What is a network firewall and how does it work? Firewall is the first line of defense in the network security, where all the incoming and the outgoing network traffic will be passing only through it. It establishes a barrier between the trusted internal networks and the untrusted outside networks, such as internet. In other words, we can also say that it separates the corporate LAN network from the outside network, outside untrusted network like internet. Okay, it monitors all the incoming and the outgoing network traffic that's passing through it, and it decides whether to permit or to deny any specific traffic based on the security policy that is defined in it. Because we will be defining a set of security policies in the firewall, and whenever a traffic is passing in or out, right? So based on that security policy, it will be either permitted to pass through it or it will be denied. Okay, fine. So this is an example, as like if you see, this is a simple topology. It's a simple example topology, I would say, where we have an untrusted external network, like maybe you can just consider this as an internet, and this is the trusted internal network. Maybe you can just consider this is the corporate LAN network, all right? So you have a couple of applications that is running within the trusted internal network, okay, like www.example.com and www.test.com, and also there is a user within the internal trusted network, all right? Maybe in the production you'll be seeing multiple zones within this as well. As I said, this is very high level understanding in this video, where we are discussing only about the basics, right? But going forward, in the upcoming videos, right, we'll be talking more in detail about the zones as well. Okay, fine. So as I said, we have untrusted external network as well as trusted internal network. Okay, if you see by the definition which we have seen in the previous slide, right, this is the front facing, right, this is the front line of first line of defense in the network security. So that you'll be seeing that at the edge, right? So it is in the front line of defense in the network security, so that it is in the edge, all right? And it separates this trusted internal network and the untrusted external network. It establishes a barrier and it separates this and this, all right? So whatever traffic that's passing through in or out, right, that to be going through only this firewall. Like when I say going in and out, it's about the network I'm referring. Like say for example, if this user, the user one or user two or the user three, right? So whenever a user want to connect to this application, that traffic should be going only through the firewall, and also the return traffic will be passing through the firewall. He cannot bypass the firewall, he cannot go directly here. All right. So whenever a traffic from the untrusted network to the trusted network, or the return traffic from the trusted to the untrusted network, all the incoming, that's what we mentioned as like all the incoming and the outgoing network traffic would be passing only through it. Okay. And as I said, firewall will be maintaining a security policy, like maybe like this. Okay. Firewall will be maintaining a security policy where all the security parameters will be, or the rules will be defined here. And whenever this, maybe let's consider this example, right? If let's consider user one want to connect to this example .com. So when his request is coming here, okay, when the request is hitting firewall, the firewall will look at the the security policy that is defined in it, and if it is set to allow, okay, if it is set to permit, then this traffic will be permitted. This traffic will be permitted to the destination, and you'll be seeing a response from that application to the firewall. Sorry, the user. All right. However, maybe let's consider that. Okay, let's consider that this user, right, this user 3, he want to connect to test.com, okay, and when his request is coming through the firewall, and maybe if there is no valid rule to allow this user's traffic to access this test.com, right? Then what happened, or if there is a rule to deny, in both ways, I would say, either there is a no valid rule to allow the traffic to pass in, or else there is a rule to deny the traffic when it's coming from user 3. In both the cases, this request would be denied, okay? And he will not be connected. He will not be connected to the application. All right. So that's the reason we are telling, whenever a traffic it's coming from the user, all the traffic would be passing only through the firewall, both the incoming and outgoing. And whenever a traffic is coming here, the firewall will look at security policy. And if it has a valid security rule or a policy to allow the traffic, then it is allowed to the destination and you'll be seeing the return traffic. If in case you don't have a valid security policy, then in that case, as like user 3, your traffic will be denied. Okay. And also very important thing, by default, there will be an implicit deny rule at the bottom. Like if any of your condition is not matching, by default, the traffic would be dropped. Okay. So in order to allow your traffic or permit your traffic to pass the destination, you should write a explicit rule like to allow the traffic, else it will be get denied. So this is how in general a firewall will work.